You damn mates. Cody? Ah, he's a good guy. He's a good guy.
Hi everyone. How are you all doing? Keeping safe and healthy, I hope. So this is a little series. There'll be four in the episode. Four episodes, even. Where I'm going to introduce you and give you a little history of each crew member. So we're starting off with Cody, which is our brown border collie cross. As if you've watched the channel, you'll know, is the most important pupper on the boat. Closely followed by Shadow, but Shadow was a later addition. So Cody we've had since she was 6 months old. She came to us through a rescue, Cheshire Rescue Dogs, I think it is. She was with a family who I don't think quite realised the amount of work that goes into looking after a dog. So they didn't want her anymore. Can you believe that? So I went to see Cody. She liked me straight away, which is nice. Took her for a walk. I had another dog then, Tessa, so we introduced them, see if they got on. And Cody's quite a placid, I'd say subservient character. She doesn't really have a dominant bone in her body. She's very gentle. She's very caring. She's just beautiful. So she's a collie and field spaniel cross. Well, that's what we were told. She's very obviously collie, predominantly. But her strange colour, we do believe, is field spaniel. I'll try and show you a picture. So let's just talk about some of Cody's personality traits. She is, well, she's getting old now, she's 13. And she's getting a bit achy and a bit leaky, but we don't care because we love her to death. She's the second most important girl on boat. Primary ones, skip a shell, obviously. So Cody is, I must have had probably 10 dogs in my lifetime, and she is without doubt the greediest I've ever known. She could literally keep eating and not stop ever. Couldn't you? She especially loves my mum, her nana, because whenever she goes round, because she's so greedy, mum thinks that's because she isn't fed. So just keeps feeding her. Which is why we can't leave her with my mum for too long, otherwise we won't be able to get her out of the house. Now, a really strange thing with Cody's behaviour is, if she meets you for the first time, or pretty much whenever she meets anybody, she'll bark at them. It's not really an aggressive bark, I think it's more a nervous, don't come near me bark. She's never bitten anybody so far. So yeah, it's really strange. I've tried to stop her doing it. Not when you're on camera. But she does. And she'll do it to people that she knows, like my sister, who's even looked after her, you know, for weeks at a time. She'll meet Julie and still bark at her. The only time it stops, really, is if you bribe her with treats. So if we have guests to the boat, we tend to give them treats together as soon as they get on. Yeah, that relaxes her. Food relaxes her.
See a theme here, can't we, fat bum?
Another funny thing she does is she'll avoid other dogs as best she can. She'll actually like cross roads and things to avoid walking past them. But as soon as they've gone past, she'll want to have a little sniff. So she'll sort of like follow them for a little snifter. She's a very strange dog. Favourite thing, other than food, is squirrels. She'll chase them in her wobbly kind of way she does now. She never catches them, obviously. And I have seen her confronted by a squirrel on a bridge, and she didn't like it. So it just goes to show, she's all mouth, no trousers. One of the things that's heartbreaking now is because, as if you've been watching for a while, you'll know that Cody's got arthritis. So she drags certain paws and walks on toes as such. So I have to be really careful now when I'm cutting her nails that I'm not cutting off, even though some may look, well, let me rephrase that. First bee of the year. So I've got to be really careful when I cut her paws that I don't cut some of the shorter ones, because they're often the ones that she rests on when she walks, because she's got a bit of a funny doddle now when she walks. She's okay when she's in a trot, which is why I try and keep her on the lead and keep her moving at a good pace. But if she's just wandering around, yeah, she's not great. So if you're cutting your own dog's toes as they get older, just bear that in mind. Because she's damn neat. This is my current view. So we're just about to cut the nails off this one. She walks well on this one. As you can see, all the nails have grown evenly. I've just taken the top off that one. But this one, there's no resistance at all to that paw. So that one I haven't hardly touched. That one's same. So yeah. She's getting old, aren't you, baby? Hey? You been good? So yeah, that's Cody. Second mate, pain in the bum, greedy. If you got any questions you've got for Cody, do put them in the comments and I'll answer them.
On her behalf, of course.
Are you going to be your girl now? Yeah. Say goodbye to everybody. So that's it for this week. Thanks very much for watching. Hope you liked that introduction to the crew. It'll either be Shell or Shadow next. So if you got any questions for Shell or Shadow, stick them in the comments and we'll address them on their episode. Till then, stay safe, stay warm, stay healthy, and we'll see you soon. Bye.
You tell me you're scared. You tell me you're weak. Stronger than what you think, and I know it's hard. Yeah, I know it's rough, but we'll make it through. Back you up. Wherever you're going, I'm going too. I'll follow you through the black and the blue. Whatever the mountain, we'll climb to the next. Honey, I'm with you through life and to death. You tell me you're nervous. You say you're afraid.